This week on Homorazzi.com, Barbara Walters released a few names on her list of the 2010 most fascinating people, and Lady Gaga talks about her new album, Born This Way. The CW shows off their first gay kiss on 90210, and America's Next Top Model crowns their Cycle 15 winner. The firemen of New York are armed and ready to heat up your 2011 calendar year, and Homorazzi.com hits a milestone. I'm your host, Tyrell Witherspoon, and this is Homorazzi Roundup. Welcome to the first edition of Homorazzi Roundup, where you're going to find out everything that happened on Homorazzi.com this week. We start off by talking about Leslie Nielsen, who died this week at the age of 84. Legendary funny man Leslie Nielsen passed away on Sunday, November 28th in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. He had been hospitalized for the past 12 days and died peacefully in his sleep with his family by his side. He had been at the hospital near his home where he was being treated for pneumonia. His nephew Doug spoke out about his uncle's passing, saying, "He was one of my best friends, and I loved him dearly. I'll miss him greatly." R&B singer Carrie Hilson released her newest video for her single, The Way You Love Me, this week, and it's directed by Skating with the Stars judge, Lori Ann Gibson. And as Donovan put it in his article, he never knew that Carrie could violently thrust her crotch in so many directions. Take a look. Following her PG-rated video for Pretty Girl Rock, Carrie Hilson has pulled a 180 and is serving some serious body gyrating in her new video for The Way You Love Me. Talk about a good girl gone bad. With Skating with the Stars judge Lori Ann Gibson directing the video, you can tell that Gibson's hands were all over it. While Donovan was hoping for a sexier feel for this video, he should have been more careful what he wishes for. Hilson has definitely turned up the sexuality on this new offering. The Way You Love Me also features a few cameos from Faith Evans, JoJo, Rick Ross, Dirty Money, and Dawn from Danity Kane. Her new album, No Boys Allowed, hits stores on December 21st. You can tell the holiday season is in full swing when top 10 lists start to hit, and Barbara Walters' Most Fascinating People list is no exception. This week, she released a few of the names that will hit this year's list, including LeBron James, Jennifer Lopez, and Justin Bieber. Let's go take a look at some of the other names that hit the list. While Justin Bieber may have been an obvious choice, Hot in Cleveland star Betty White also hit the Fascinating People list.
What did you think of my mall walk, mate?
Not bad. A little surprised by all the Justin Bieber.
Really? I love her!
The cast of MTV's smash hit The Jersey Shore made the list, as well as Alaska's very own Sarah Palin. The name of the most fascinating person won't be revealed until her ABC special hits the airwaves on December 9th. Lady Gaga's newest album, Born This Way, is set for release in 2011. And here's what she had to say to her Polish fans while on tour. The anticipation for Lady Gaga's newest album project, Born This Way, has been high, and Lady Gaga herself has been majorly talking it up. With 20 tracks rumored to be on the album, Lady Gaga said this to her Polish fans while on tour. "I promise you I'll never let you down, and not for nothing. The album's finished, and it's good. So whatever you just did for all of us, I promise to give you the greatest album of this decade just for you." Born This Way is set to hit stores February 2011. The CW came out of the closet this week on 90210 when Teddy and Ian shared their first kiss on screen.
Need any help?
Yeah, that'd be great. Thanks.
Baby, I'm through waiting, 'cause I need you now. I'll show you how you can take my hand and save me. Come on, save me.
It's the moment I know a lot of you have been waiting for.
America's Next Top Model.
Yes. After some intense deliberations, Accidental Model Anne took the crown of America's Next Top Model Cycle 15. It was a shock to some viewers as Chelsea had won many challenges and won over many of the judges and the photographers. Homorazzi.com writer Rich, who recaps the show, stated that this was one of the more obvious wins in all 15 cycles. Congratulations to Anne. This season of Survivor couldn't be more intense, and this week, the intensity took the toll of two castaways.
Let's get down to the decision. Right now, Nayanka, you have a 1 in 9 shot at $1 million. Yes or no, are you going to stay in this game and fight for a shot to win it, or are you going to quit?
I'm going to quit.
Nayanka's going to quit. Purple Kelly, you now have a 1 in 8 shot at winning this game. Your odds just improved with Nayanka quitting. You're going to stay and fight, or you're going to quit?
I'm going to quit.
Purple Kelly's going to quit.
In the season's most shocking tribal council, contestants Kelly and Nayanka both decide to quit after surviving 28 days in Nicaragua.
What happened to theirs? They got smushed. Is that the word, smushed?
After much discussion, host Jeff Probst agreed to snuff out both of their torches, but stated he would leave them at tribal council as a reminder to them while on the jury that they quit the game so early on.
Alright, so I'll snuff your torches.
The Grammy nominations were announced in high style this year, hosted by LL Cool J, with performances by Katy Perry, B.O.B., Bruno Mars, and of course, Justin Bieber. Let's take a look at some of the nominees. Up for Best New Artist are Justin Bieber, Drake, Florence and the Machine, Mumford & Sons, and Esperanza Spalding. Rounding out the Song of the Year category are Ray LaMontagne for Beg, Steal or Borrow, CeeLo Green for Forget You, Miranda Lambert for The House That Built Me, Eminem featuring Rihanna for Love the Way You Lie, and Lady Antebellum for Need You Now. Eminem leads the nomination trail with 10 nods, while Bruno Mars isn't far behind with 7. Lady Gaga, Lady Antebellum, and Jay-Z are all tied for 6 nods apiece. The 53rd Annual Grammy Awards will air live on CBS February 13th, 2011. This week, the site reached a milestone when we hit over 1 million page views for the month of November. Now, we couldn't have done it with all the love and support from our loyal readers, and to thank you, we thought we'd show you one of our first promotional videos when Homorazzi.com first launched.
What's up, sexy?
And you don't care what they say.
Now I've got a confession. When I was young, I wanted attention. I promised myself that I'd do anything. Anything at all for them to notice me. But I ain't complaining. We all wanna be famous. So go ahead and say what you wanna say. You know what it's like to be nameless. Wanna know what your name is. Cause see, when I was younger, I would say, when I grow.
Entertainment Weekly named its 2010 Entertainers of the Year. The list includes James Franco, John Hamm, Katy Perry, and Jaden and Willow Smith. But top honors went to none other than country superstar Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift started 2010 strong with a hit movie, a hit single, and won 4 Grammy Awards, including Album of the Year. Then, during the middle of the year, she performed to sold-out crowds on her headlining tour. In the fall, she released her 3rd album, Speak Now, which sold a jaw-dropping 1,047,000 copies in its first week alone. With that total, she broke numerous records, and the CD continues to perform well due to strong reviews and radio airplay. Currently, Taylor Swift is dating super hottie Jake Gyllenhaal, who is 9 years her senior. What keeps adding fuel to her private life is Swift's tendency to write about her ex-boyfriends in her hit songs. She discussed this in the interview with Entertainment Weekly. She says, "Sometimes I would laugh because I would see it in print and it would say, this song which is written about her ex so-and-so, and they would write about it as if it was fact. The fact is, I haven't ever confirmed that any song is about any particular person. There's something kind of freeing about that. As far as I'm concerned, it's all still up in the air." There's no question that Taylor Swift has had a banner year and that she was the right choice for Entertainer of the Year. Are you looking for something to heat up your 2011 year? Well, look no further. The Firefighters of New York have released their newest 2011 calendar entitled City of the Brave. Let's check out some of the hotties. Well, that's a wrap for this week. Don't forget to check out www.homorazzi.com for all your celebrity gossip and news. Plus, check out our 2010 holiday gift guide. I'm your host, Tyrell Witherspoon, and this was Homorazzi Roundup.